Well, I'm joined in the studio today by Claire Wearn. Claire is part of Brighton's Photo Fringe, a biannual exhibition that takes place across the city. Welcome to Latest TV, Claire.
Thank you for having me.
It's an amazing project, something that I've been going to for years now. When did it actually start?
It started in 2003, and not by myself, but by wonderful photographers that were based in Brighton, many of whom are still here, but people like Danny Wilson and Gordon MacDonald, Lisa Craig, and people that wanted to have their own photographic exhibition alongside the curated Brighton Photo Biennial, as it was then.
And how many people are actually exhibiting this year?
Well, we haven't counted up yet. So, I mean, we're still in, we're just approaching the deadline this Friday for people to register. So Photo Fringe is the sum of all its parts. You've got exhibitions that are happening through open calls that we've been running, and then all the photo fringes themselves that set up their own exhibitions. And so at the minute we seem to have around 40 different exhibitions by self-curating, self-organising photo fringe exhibitors. But the official deadline is Friday, so we'll do the final count then. But it's one of our busiest so far.
You use the phrase self-curating. People can actually register and exhibit what they like to exhibit.
Yeah.
Which is, I think, is so exciting because you see things that other people make decisions to dismiss. I like seeing the stuff that doesn't get through.
Exactly. So that's we call it an open platform festival. And what we mean by that, people say, what do you mean, Claire? What's that? And it's been used far before I was involved in Photo Fringe. But it really means that it's open to anyone that wants to take part. People that are hobbyists or other levels of photographic practice, making work with cameras or moving image, but mainly photography, can set up their own exhibitions. And so in the run-up to the festival, we spend lots of time with people talking to them about if they're starting a project, if they're maybe not sure whether to exhibit it, if they haven't done that before, how do you do that? But everyone's welcome, so everyone's invited to take part.
Of course, these days, everyone is a photographer. Mm. We all have smartphones. They all have excellent cameras in them.
We do.
But also, with a laptop, with a computer, we're all brilliant at using the technology that exists to edit and to manipulate images. Do you think that's changed the nature of photography over the last 15 years?
Yeah, no doubt. And I think that's always part of the conversation. And with every Photo Fringe Festival, we're always, that's why it's so good that so many different people take part. We've got a huge contingent of diehard analog photographers that are, you know, film-based and hand-printing their work, through to people that are, now, you know, AI-generating work and doing everything on that whole spectrum of photographic practice and making. But that's sort of what keeps the conversation alive, because those, everyone can connect during the festival, whether you're working with, you know, a really old film camera, or whether you're doing the opposite and working with, you know, a smartphone or some apps, then everyone can get together and have those sorts of discussions, and then we share everything. So we're not censoring or editing out. If people want to show those different types of work, they can. Back in 2018, I wasn't working on the festival then, but I think the festival was titled Photography Changes Everything. So it really kind of digs in every time to those sorts of questions that you're thinking about.
As well as exhibitions, are there events where people come along and talk about these arts?
Yes, yes, totally. So we'll organise some events ourselves. So it starts, I should say, on Friday the 4th of October, and it runs this time until the 17th of November, because we have more exhibitions and events happening than ever before. And our home has always been Brighton and Hove, but for the first time we're supporting exhibitors in Portsmouth, and we have exhibitions and events in New Haven, which are amazing actually, in the marine workshops.
Yes.
They have fantastic events. They're more into November, but there'll be walks and processions where people can talk together about photography as they go. And then there will be events around some of the exhibitions. So in Duke's Lane, we've got one of the lovely pop-up shops there. And Spectrum with the British Culture Archive are having an exhibition, which is going to be amazing. It's through Open Call, but in response to very famous photographer Tish Murtha's work, social documentary photography. And so the people running British Culture Archive will be having an informal talk around their work, which is on Saturday the 5th of October. And there are so many more, so you have to just log into photofringe.org to find out. There is so much on.
I think that's the most exciting thing about this, is actually going and seeing new work, but being inspired by new work and actually hearing from the artists, because they are artists.
I think that's what's really lovely about Photo Fringe, is that, you know, we're in Brighton, there aren't lots of visual arts galleries. We're really good at using meanwhile spaces and pop-up shops, cafes. So here in Kemp Town, we're in Kemp Town at the moment, the wonderful Cafe Portland, the brilliant bookshop, Jonah Jeremy's The Bookend, Mid Street Lab, that whole run, there's going to be all these little pop-up shows. And so you're going to a bookshop and you'll see a photography exhibition on the wall, and the people working in the bookshop will be there. And so if the artist isn't there, the people that know about the exhibition are there. And there's always a chance to kind of have that conversation if you want to. If you're looking at the work, you just want to look at the work and leave, that's really fine too. But there are, I think, with fringe venues, you get that extra thing, don't you, where you can chat to people.
Yes, I mean, Brighton's famous for its artist open houses. Yeah, one of the great things about artist open houses is that when the exhibitions are open, the artists are there and you can meet them and talk to them. Will most of the photographers be there?
It really varies. It really depends. And we're definitely not set up like artist open houses in that they're not in people's homes. So people hire venues like small galleries throughout the city and elsewhere, but also people use free spaces like cafes and bookshops. And there's a brilliant couple of local young photographers, recent graduates, that have found and got permission to use the Imperial Arcade, which is under development.
Yes, that's changing as we speak. Yeah.
So, but they're going to do a really dynamic exhibition using the hoardings in that space. So they won't be there every day because that's really difficult for them. But, you know, there'll be opportunities when they'll pop up and they'll do a talk. So on our website, we'll always list when the artists are around, and there should be other opportunities to see them.
I'm always interested in seeing work done by very young people. Are there any very young photographers?
Yeah, so we always run an open call for budding photographers between the ages of 14 and 18. And this year we've actually relocated that to Portsmouth because we're starting sort of new conversations in Portsmouth. So we're running it in Portsmouth for schools and colleges and people to respond to there, and working with Aspects Gallery, which, you know, we've known forever, so it's really nice to be working with them. And then the young people's work that will be selected will be shown in a gallery and printed by us, and they're responding to the theme of common ground, which is something for them to explore themselves and think about.
Themes are always good, but you've not set a theme this year.
We have this loose theme of common ground, which is really for the open call, so for people like the young photographers to have something to get their teeth into. So really thinking about, where do you find that middle space if you're all experiencing different lived experiences? What's that common ground? How do you find that together? And or people can interpret it in their own way. So yeah, hopefully we're looking forward to seeing what they produce.
And are people going to see your work, Claire?
I'm not a photographer. I'm not. I know it's quite outrageous, maybe shocking, but no, I've spent my life, luckily, fortunately, working alongside artists. I'm very much interested in trying to set up the conditions and the spaces for people to show their work. I believe it's really important that we keep art available for everyone to be able to see.
And of course, most of these exhibitions are free to view.
Yeah, they're all free. We always make sure that all our exhibitions are free, so they're all free entry. Yeah, we welcome everyone.
Are they grouped in particular areas of the city?
Not really. So we don't run it like AOH. We don't do trails, but there sort of inevitably is or are as well. I don't know, check my grammar on that. But so there's a real cluster of shows in Kemp Town, like I said, at The Bookend, Mid Street Lab, Portland, and then connecting to the University of the School of Photography, of course. We've got an amazing set of photography tutors and professors there that always, they've either been in Photo Fringe themselves or they are champions of Photo Fringe. So they're really corralling their students into shows for October in Edward Street campus.
Excellent, excellent. Mm. Well, it's always wonderful to hear about things. I'm so glad that you do it outside of the festival season.
Yeah.
When the competition is just too demanding.
It is, and also the demand on spaces and everything. So, yeah, I mean, it's always been, I think, since 2003, it's always been in October. Correct me if I'm wrong, someone watching. But as far as I know, and people always say, why then? You know, it's really busy time, but it's always a busy time of year, whatever month you pick. And so everyone's back to uni. So we've got lots of nice things going on with the students.
Kids are at school. Plenty of time.
Yeah.
You go out and see some exhibitions.
Exactly.
Find some in a cafe. Have a cup of coffee.
Definitely.
And a cake,
yeah.
And enjoy it.
Yeah.
Reminders for the dates again and the website.
So I would encourage everyone to really good starting point is Phoenix Art Space. They're one of our main partners and long-standing partners, and we'll have our opening there on Friday the 4th of October. Many other exhibitions will be open as well, so you just check out the website, photofringe.org.
So thank you so much for coming in and talking to us.
No worries. Thank you for having me.